A guy might have put that life behind him 10 years ago and you're still holding against him. Give a person a chance. They're part of our society. They live, one day they could be your neighbor.
In his own words, Rick Wershe is telling us not only what he's lived through, but why there's an urgent need to reform how our society treats those being released from prison. More than 32 years since he was locked up for a nonviolent drug crime as a teenager, Rick is back on Detroit's East Side, rolling up his sleeves to help.
I had heard about Team Wellness doing good things in the city for years, and I was immediately attracted to the organization.
He took us inside one of several Wayne County locations to show us a place treating people differently than a prison would. Rick says people here want a hand up, not a hand out.
No one's turned away. They have mental health, dental, drug rehabilitation. Everything that the people need in this area is offered at this facility.
Rick says he's committed to helping start a juvenile diversion program in Wayne County and is willing to work with the governor to help stop mass incarceration.
The saying that you paid your debt to society, to me, is a foolish statement, because when you're incarcerated, you're actually costing society more money.
He says helping former inmates is also a win for taxpayers.
We're in Wayne County. I believe 80% of our prison system, which costs $2 billion a year to the taxpayers, is from Wayne County.
Team Wellness Vice President Michael Hunter is head of operations here.
Getting out of prison isn't the answer. The answer is being set free. We've learned to stop saying, "What's wrong with you?" And instead we ask, "What happened? How do we get here?"
Rick now spends time regularly sharing his story and offering positive support here. In addition, there are mental health experts, doctors, job skills providers, and others equipped to turn lives around.
A lot of people who have brushes with the law have an underlying mental illness and or substance abuse. So when they come out, being able to address that and get into treatment as quickly as possible will improve their chances of success.
The need for this type of help, funded by Medicaid dollars, is major. Outside the facility, we find a much less hopeful place on the streets, an abandoned church, a littered area near a liquor store, and little opportunity for someone returning from prison.
A person's gonna do what they have to do to survive. And if that person has to commit a crime because they're hungry or they don't have clothes, if we can provide those services, I think it'll make the community a much safer place.
Detroit Wayne Integrated Health Network CEO Willie Brooks Jr. is among those advocating for the same cause as Rick.
The number one thing that drives people to change is when people realize that someone actually cares.
His agency is working hard to ensure funding is there for places like Team Wellness.
Every individual that they turn around generates revenue, generates a change in society.
Brooks agrees a rise in crime and stigma surrounding mental health have also contributed to the need for more mental health treatment.
How many times they have been raped? How many times they were abused? How many times they were left homeless? How many times they didn't know if they would live the next day?
In prison, they can only do so much. You know, there's 1,000 people. There might be 5 psychologists or 4 psychologists in a prison. As society, when these people come out of prison, is where they need more help.
Judge Shannon Holmes from 36th District Mental Health Court also is part of a movement Rick supports.
I send people to Team Wellness. They have actually partnered with us at Mental Health Court. I get the opportunity to address the whole person. And when I say the whole person, I address the physical as well as the mental and the emotional.
Rick tells us developing life skills gives former offenders the foundation to care for themselves, learning to pay their own bills, finding patience and inner strength, and believing in yourself.
At some point, some people need some help, and Team Wellness is offering that help.
His crusade has also led to more consulting opportunities. He also currently partners with Chicago law firm Hale and Monaco to assist with cases involving criminal defense and civil rights violations. And Rick says he wants his legacy to be what he's accomplished after being released from prison.
This is his passion, is to give back and to help.
His fiancee and biggest supporter tells us she's incredibly proud of all he's doing to raise awareness.
He's genuine, he's giving, he's kind, he's truthful about it, and he cares. I mean, the key word is that he cares. It never broke him.
I've had people ask me, "Man, why'd you come back here? There's nothing here." This is where I'm from. This is my city. If I can help people here that no one else will help, I'm going to help them.
Rick continues to get so much support from the suburbs to the city, and he says that's a big reason he stays so motivated. From Detroit's East Side, Simon Shaykat, 7 Action News.
Returning to help his hometown. Nice to see. Thank you, Simon.